During the 3 years project DiveIN, developing eduLARP methodology to prevent violent radicalization of young people, our partner consortium has been working on answering the question of how eduLARP, educational live action role-playing games, can work on prevention of violent radicalization. We have described radicalization through the Moghaddam model. It nicely pointed out that radicalization is essentially neutral and people can be at the different stages of it. At some stages, however, the possibility of accepting violence is more probable when certain conditions are met. It's an extremely interesting concept and we have adopted it in our research as a source of definitions. Based on that, we had to detect criteria, features that would inhibit development of acceptance towards different types of violence: systemic, symbolic, physical, emotional. Extensive literature analysis showed that there is an index of attitudes that create immune system resistance towards demagogy, narrations dehumanizing others, turning sense of injustice into a violent act towards the others. And those features are, first of all, general empathy, ability to understand motives, reasons, and behaviors from all sides of socio-political conflicts. It brings also prevention of dehumanizing others by understanding their positions, growth of critical thinking, as well as growth of the habit of self-doubting, exercising the consequences of their own beliefs. Second of all, this is self-agency, self-efficacy, confidence connected with sense of belonging to the socio-political community or system, resulting in verbalizing and realizing needs within legitimate means. And lastly, growth of understanding of own role in a community of diverse groups and individuals. Basically prevents alienation and isolation. Our research showed that eduLARPs, carefully conducted and directed to achievements of those aims, namely 5 scenarios designed and redesigned exactly for this purpose, have brought deep change and wide impact on majority of participants. We have observed over 300 players, their debriefings and processes of change. 70 of them expressed their views in the questionnaire, and 30 took part in a focus group interviews. The results convinced us that even though LARP is a demanding tool, it is one of the few that can bring such a profound change. It can work on deeply embedded attitudes. Of course, not every LARP works on radicalization, and not every LARP is educational. In order to know how to organize educational games and which traits are particularly effective to work on the issue of radicalization, dive into our publication.